Greetings, people of YouTube. My name is Daniela, and I'm back with another video. This is a world record for me. I am fully decked out in my gator gear today. I'm wearing this UF sweater, and I'm also wearing UF socks today. I recently just finished my spring semester of my freshman year at the University of Florida, and I could not have loved it more than I did. I honestly can't imagine myself anywhere else. So I'm under the impression that incoming freshmen are feeling around in the dark, trying to figure out how to maneuver their freshman year without being able to physically go see the university or physically talk to anyone that has already experienced their freshman year and can give them tips. So here's where I come in. I've watched countless of these videos, especially last summer before I started my freshman year. I noticed one thing that was consistent in all of these videos. Each video was one person's experience. And while that can be immensely helpful, I thought it would be even better if I got the opinions of a lot of people. I took to Instagram and I posted the following question. If you go to UF, what tips/advice would you give to any incoming freshman? So here I am to relay the answers to you in a YouTube video that you can come back to later. And best of all, you don't have to physically go anywhere. You can watch this from the comfort of your home. While this video is tailored toward specifically UF students, this could probably help out any college student, especially those that are going into their freshman year and are super unsure about what to expect. Honestly, most of the people that responded to my question said tips that I personally agree with and feel no need to reiterate. So I am just going to go through all the tips that I have written down here and just hit you with a bunch of information and advice, like a loving big sister or a good friend or, I don't know, somebody else who cares about your well-being. So the first piece of advice that I have for you is take advantage of your freshman fall. It's the easiest semester you'll have, and ooh, baby, do I agree with that statement. Honestly, there was a huge difference in the difficulty between my freshman fall curriculum and my freshman spring curriculum. It was immensely harder in the spring. In the fall, it was sort of challenging to get acclimated to college courses, but the spring just hit me like a load of bricks. Many a mental breakdown stemmed from the things that I had to endure during my spring semester. So follow this advice and do take advantage of your fall semester, because that's most likely the easiest semester that you're gonna have in your entire college career. If you're starting in the summer, the same goes for you. Second piece of advice that I have is the first people you hang out with aren't necessarily going to be your people. You're likely gonna meet a lot of people that you hit it off with, but don't be offended or get sad if that person doesn't turn out to be a lifelong or even year-long friend, because finding your little group is sort of something that happens naturally, and chances are that the first people that you meet will not be the people that you will maintain friendships with, and that's totally okay, because you have to feel it out and see which friendships are right for you, and other people are trying to do the same thing. So don't get frustrated if you don't find a group of friends or even a friend right off the bat. Third piece of advice, don't compare yourself to others. Everyone has a path, be confident in yours. This is something that is very hard to do and something that I personally struggle with as well. So trust me, you are not alone. It's very easy to compare yourself to other students, especially when you're in a college as big as UF. I can imagine that it's also hard for people at universities that have a smaller student population, but UF is home to over 50,000 students. It's very likely that even if you were the smartest person at your high school, there are gonna be a lot of people at UF that are smarter than you, because UF is a really hard school to get into. And that's totally okay. A little friendly competition never hurt anybody. Honestly, for me, it motivates me a lot more to know that there are people out there that are studying their butts off and getting better grades than I am, or doing more things than I am, because it pushes me to want to do more, study more, excel more. However, you need to make sure that competing with other people does not take up all of your energy. You need to regroup every once in a while and stop comparing yourself to others, because everybody has their own journey and everybody takes different steps to get to their final destination. No matter how cheesy that may sound, it's very true. The fourth piece of advice that I have is to join student orgs, because it's a great place to meet people with similar interests. not even lying, the strongest friendships that I made my freshman year were with people that I met through organizations. And it makes sense because these are people that have things in common with you and are likely going to be compatible with you in a friendship. This is not to say that just because you join a student organization, you're gonna instantly find a best friend in it, but it does up your chances of finding somebody who you'd vibe with and eventually be able to strengthen a friendship with. Also, you can join a cultural organization. Personally, I met a lot of friends through Hispanic clubs and organizations that I got involved with. It was easy to relate to them because we have similar backgrounds. Also, if you're religious, there are religious clubs and organizations and off-campus worship centers where you can meet people that share your faith, and that could possibly lead you to finding friendships that will last. Fifth piece of advice, be open to making friends in unexpected places. While you can meet very good friends at structured organizational events, you can also meet friends in random places, such as when you're riding the bus to class, or when you're walking to class, or when you're buying a coffee, even in a big lecture hall. You never know who you're gonna click with, so I suggest just being nice and being open to having a conversation with somebody that you may not know. I know that this is very hard to do from personal experience because there are times where I'm walking through campus and I just want to have my AirPods in and I don't want to talk to anybody, and that's totally okay. I have done that many a time and I'm sure that you will too. Even if you don't have AirPods, you'll probably have earbuds in or headphones or whatever it is that blocks out the rest of the world. Trust me, I get it. But if one day you happen to be in a talking mood and there's someone nearby who also seems to be in a talking mood, why not talk to them? Sixth tip that I have for you. Don't get a meal plan unless you have a scholarship that completely pays for it. I did not have a meal plan my freshman year. No matter how much you have pushed for every single freshman to get it, I did not get it. And I did not starve to death. And to be honest, I think I saved a lot of money. I know that the meal plan is really expensive and you don't need to be spending all that money on food. Because trust me, at the end of the semester, you're gonna be scrambling to spend those extra flex bucks that you have, or whatever extra money that you have on your meal plan, and it's gonna be a waste. What my best friend and I did is that we went grocery shopping all the time, and while I know that this is not feasible for everybody, it was a really great alternative to having a meal plan or to eating out all the time. The next tip that I received was to join older Facebook class groups to get textbooks. So if you have no idea what I'm talking about, there are different groups on Facebook for each graduating class at UF. So there's class of 2024, class of 2023, class of 2022, and so on and so forth. While I personally didn't join any older class groups, I can see how this would be a really great idea because textbooks are expensive and people tend to want to get rid of them, so they sell them for really cheap prices. This is just a little insider's tip for you. I'm trying to save you that coin. The next tip is to get a football season pass. This was one of the best decisions that I made my freshman year because I just got the season pass, and then the games that I didn't go to, I sold the tickets, and people are willing to pay good money for those tickets. And honestly, I only missed out on one or two games because going to games is so much fun. It was essential to my freshman year experience, and I highly, highly, highly recommend it. Even if you don't like sports, because I hate sports, and I loved going to the football games and the tailgates. It was so much fun. Those are some of the best memories that I have from my freshman year, and I definitely don't regret getting the season pass. The next tip is to eat Krishna. Krishna lunch is delicious. It is so good and I miss it so much. I would die for that almond dressing right now. It is so good. If you don't know what Krishna lunch is, it's a lunch that is sold by a group called the Krishnas every weekday at the Plaza of the Americas. It's delicious, it's only $5, and it's vegetarian. Every day there's a different meal, so you won't get bored of it, and you can serve yourself as many times as you want. So you can pay, get your meal for that day, eat it, and then go back with your Tupperware and get seconds and take it home for the next day. Even more tips to save you money and convince you to not get the meal plan because it's a scam. The next tip is to live in the dorms your freshman year. I lived in a dorm my freshman year and I do not regret it at all. While the dorm was a little musty sometimes, I grew to love it a lot, and I loved being on campus, especially since I was a freshman and I wasn't super familiarized with all the locations on campus. My dorm was close to literally everything. It was a perfect location, and I actually met a lot of people that I became friends with through my dorm. So if you're an incoming freshman and you're considering getting an apartment, I am here to convince you that the dorm life is where it's at least for your freshman year. The final tip is something that I've already said, but I'm going to reiterate it because I feel like it's important. Don't be afraid to just talk to people. Branching out is the best way to make friends. While it may seem daunting to make friends, at a university as big as UF, there are people out there who want to be your friend and will be there for you and care about you. As long as you put yourself out there, you will likely find somebody that becomes a lifelong friend. But you can't expect to make friends if you're just cooped up in your dorm all the time. So even if you don't feel like going to anything social, I think your best bet would be to just set it up and go, because you never know who you might meet and what friendships you may make. And if you don't make friends at the events that you go to, at least you won't have to sit around wondering what if. So that is all I got for you today. I could talk about this subject for hours and hours and hours, but I don't want to make this video super long. If you happen to have watched all the way to the end and you still want more tips, reach out to me and I can make another one of these videos, or I can talk to you. I am here and I'm currently not busy for the summer, so I would be more than happy to discuss college life with you or anything else that you may want to discuss. I hope this video was helpful, and go Gators!